मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड अबाउट व्हाट इज फ्लावर, पार्ट्स ऑफ फ्लावर, सेपल, पेटल, एंड्रोशियम एंड गाइनोशियम, रिगार्डिंग एंथर एंड फिलामेंट, रिगार्डिंग द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ पोलन ग्रेन दैट इज माइक्रोस्पोरोजेनेसिस. इन द टुडे लेक्चर फॉर डेज पोलन. Start with pollen. Pollen is the male gametophyte. Means pollen grain yields gametes, male gametes. Pollen grain has two layer, that is exine or entine. Exine is the outermost layer, and exine is made up of sporopollenin, which is the most resistant organic material present. This material can withstand in high temperature condition, high acidic basic condition, and this organic material not rupture with the action of any enzyme. Exine layer has an aperture known as germ pore. Germ pore is the area where this organic material is absent. That is, sporopollenin is absent in the germ pore area in the pollen grain. Inner layer is known as entine. Inner layer is continuous in nature, whereas exine layer has a aperture known as germ pore. Inner layer is known as entine, and it is made up of cellulose and pectin. When the pollen grain get mature, it contain two cell. First one is vegetative, second one is generative cell. How can we differentiate vegetative or generative cell? Vegetative cell is large in size. Vegetative cell is large in size, whereas generative cell is small in size. The function of vegetative cell is to store food material. And the function of generative cell is to formation of gametes. You can see in the figure, this is germ pore, this is exine, entine, this one. Exine is outermost layer, entine is in inner layer, and this exine layer has some irregular thickenings, and through germ pore the pollen grain get germinate, and it leads to formation of pollen tube. These are the male cells in the last, this one. Next, now these are some additional facts about pollen grain. Pollen grain may leads to have several health disease, that is, it cause allergy or asthma. Pollen grain, when enter in the respiratory tract of human being, it will leads to, sometime it will leads to sneezing or running nose. So several allergies reaction can be visualized if a person have a symptom of pollen allergy. Second, pollen grain of parthenium or carrot grass causes pollen allergy. Parthenium is a plant. The pollen grain of parthenium cause pollen allergy. Third important point, pollen grain are rich in nutrient. Rich in nutrient, so it can be used in food as a food supplements. Pollen grain can be eaten, yes. Fourth point, when the pollen grain moves out from anther, it has a definite or specific time within which it can germinate. This is known as pollen viability. Pollen viability is the ability of pollen grain to germinate within a specific period of time. The viability of pollen grain differ in differ species. That is, wheat and rice has 30 minutes of pollen viability. Means if the pollen grain release from wheat and rice, then it is viable only for 30 minutes. If the pollen grain lands on the stigma within 30 minutes, the pollen grain get germinate. In Rosaceae, Leguminaceae and Solanaceae, they remain viable for months. Now, pollen grain can be stored for several years in liquid nitrogen, and the temperature of liquid nitrogen is minus 196 degree centigrade. Next, the pistil. Pistil, Megasporangium and embryo sac. The pollen grain, Microsporogenesis. Here, the female gamete production and the about the pistil is will be discussed. Stigma in the figure, style and ovary. Stigma, style, ovary combine to form a pistil. Stigma is the landing platform for this one. Stigma is the landing platform for pollen grain. Style is the tube-like structure. Style is the tube-like structure which connects stigma to the ovary. And through style, pollen tube germinate. This is the passage for pollen tube. First, gynoecium. Gynoecium is the female reproductive part. Stamen is the male reproductive part. Or androecium is the male reproductive part and gynoecium is the female reproductive part. If the pistil is single pistil is present, then this is monocarpillary. If more than one pistil is present, then it is termed as multicarpillary. Sometimes pistils are fused and sometimes pistils are free. If the pistils are fused, then they are termed as syncarpus. Note down. If the pistils are fused, they are termed as syncarpus, and the pistils are free, they are termed as apocarpus. This point is already discussed. Each pistil has a three parts, stigma, style and ovary. Inside the ovary, there is a cavity known as ovarian cavity. And the placenta is located inside the ovarian cavity. And ovule arise from placenta, means ovule connected with the ovary with the help of a placenta. The number of ovule may be single or many. And ovary give rise to the formation of fruit and ovule give rise to the formation of seed. Yes, in this slide, the fused and free conditions are shown here. This one, B figure, this ovary is syncarpus. Syncarpus means fused. And in the C figure, free structures are present. This is apocarpus. Apocarpus and multicarpillary. Now, what is Megasporangium? Microsporangium and Megasporangium. In this, we will study about ovule or Megasporangium. Ovule is connected with the ovary with the help of a placenta in the first step. This ovule is a small structure attached to the placenta of locule with a stalk called as funicle. This one is the structure. This is the connection of ovule, funicle. The body of ovule fused with the funicle in the region called as ilium. This is the area, ilium, connected. Ilium is the junction between funicle and ovule. You can note down. I am repeating again. Ovule is connected with the placenta with a stalk called as funicle, and the body of ovule fused with the funicle in the region called as ilium, and ilium is the junction between funicle and ovule. Each ovule has one or two protective covering. Means ovule contain one or two protective covering named as integuments. This one. These are integuments. Outer integuments and inner integuments. You can easily visualize this. This one. Integuments cover the ovule. You can see all over integument is present except and the opening at the top called as microvilli. This is the area where integuments are absent. This one. Opposite to the micropyle, there is a end known as chalazaland. This one. This one. So, ovule contain two ends. One is micropyle, second is chalazal. Micropyle end does not have a covering of integuments, and chalazal end is just present opposite to the micropyle end. This is all about. Thanks.